Time is 6 p.m. Council of City of Denison now convenes into regular session. Tonight's invocation will be given by Pastor Larry Goodwin from the Refuge Church.
Bow your heads with me. Heavenly Father, we thank you for this day. We thank you for the opportunity to live in this great city. And I just come to you tonight and we ask for your wisdom. We ask for your guidance. Father, I pray for our mayor and every member of this council, every person that governs our city. We pray for wisdom, that they could govern with your wisdom in challenging times. Father, I pray for the agenda tonight. I pray that our council would be able to work together in harmony with our city and the citizens of our city, and that you would receive glory in everything that we do. Father, I pray for every member of this governing body that they would find peace in their personal lives and joy in their homes and families, that you would continue to honor us with the privilege to be participants in your kingdom and making the light shine here in Denison, Texas. We thank you for that privilege, and we give all praise to you. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Amen. To the flag of the United States of America, and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Agenda item number two, proclamation and presentation. About a year ago, the City Council adopted a new award. We call it the Moving Forward, Giving Back Award. It goes with the slogan of the city of Moving Forward, Kicking Back, and this is Moving Forward, Giving Back. And tonight we will be giving out our second award, and what it's designed to do is, man, we couldn't possibly give awards to every great volunteer in this city. The volunteers that we have in Denison, whether it's with the city or with the local sports leagues or the school district or the nonprofits, is really amazing and it makes Denison special. What the awards are designed to do is to really recognize those that really go above and beyond in their volunteering and their giving back to this community. And so tonight it's a great privilege for us to get to recognize the Denison Animal Welfare Group, also known as DOG. I guess y'all been in existence for how long? Who can speak with you?
Since 2014.
Since 2014. Come up forward if you would. And if you would, state your name for those who don't know.
I'm Stephanie Phillips. I'm the Executive Director of DOG.
Very good. Thank you for being here tonight. And so since 2014, and through that, for those that don't know, the relationship between this group and the city has really blossomed into something that I think is really a mutually beneficial relationship. And at the end of the day, our whole community benefits from that. You'll see a lot of times in communities our size and large ones that you'll get an animal welfare group that have, I guess, sometimes what I would call the wrong intentions. And you guys really are just about trying to do the right thing for as many animals as possible, recognizing that the city also has limitations as well. And what you guys have been able to do, both in increasing your adoption rates, in utilizing the old Southside Fire Station, which again is a great partnership with the city, getting out in the public, creating awareness, the recent grant, the $5,000 grant, $10,000 grant, again is a testament to the work you guys do. And so it's an honor for us to recognize you. I'll present this to you and we can take a picture, but I want to give you a chance to say anything that you want
okay.
to say.
Okay. So, like I said, I'm Stephanie Phillips. I'm the Executive Director of DOG. I'm joined tonight by several board members and just a few of my wonderful volunteers, as you can see. I want to thank the mayor and the city council for inviting us here tonight and recognizing this group of phenomenal volunteers. Without their selfless dedication, we've never been able to be so successful. To date, we've had more than 25,000 volunteer hours recorded and many more unrecorded. Our mission has always been to save healthy, adoptable animals from suffering and needless euthanasia. We continue to work towards this goal and getting closer every year. In 2014, we saved 307 animals. Excuse me. 2015, 638. 2016, we doubled that again to 1,178 animals. Our next goal is to see a new shelter built And to make that happen, we've been very frugal and managed to set aside $100,000 towards that goal. We appreciate the city's continued confidence in us and look forward to partnering with you to see that achieved. Thank you again for your support in this awesome award.
Very nice. Those stats are really stunning. They're really stunning. Again, it's a testament to the work you've done. And one other, this is just a small example, but the pride that you take in the facility, it's aware. I know somebody's getting there early most every day.
Is that right? Every day.
Every day, yeah, because I see lights on and the sun's not come up yet. The pride that you took in just taking the effort to put Christmas lights outside. You know, again, it's on our gateway. People see that. And there's just a lot of pride that your group has shown in doing that. We're proud of you and glad that you're a part.
So thank you very much.
Can I have some of the volunteers?
Absolutely, whoever.
Bruce, Kathy. These are a couple of my board members.
Your seat. There's a lot of cameras, just kind of look in the middle.
Okay.
You know they can text those and share them. Before the council goes into the consent agenda, for those that haven't been here a lot from the animal welfare group, I will give you a chance to leave right now if you're not wanting to stick to the next 10 items.
Yes. Again, that's just a testament to what good energy does. A lot of right people, good people working in the same direction. And that's why it's really good. Agenda number 3, consent agenda.
Motion to approve.
Second.
I have a motion from Councilman Brawley, second from Councilman Hanley. All in favor by saying aye.
Aye.
Opposed like sign. Motion carries. Agenda item 4A, public hearings. First one is an unsafe structure of 144 Doolittle Avenue. Ms. Gordon.
Good evening, Council. On November 9, 2016, U.S. Bank and Rebecca A. Walton were given notice to repair and demolish the structure at 144 Doolittle. The owners have failed to comply with the notice. This structure is unsafe and considered a fire hazard. This structure is open, creating an attractive nuisance. The roof is in pretty bad condition. The taxes haven't been paid on this property since 2011. So there's a little over $2,700 due on it. A record of the violation notices an unsafe condition of the property on file in the building department. Staff is recommending council declare the structure an unsafe structure and order its removal.
Okay, this is a public hearing. Is there anyone here wishing to speak to this agenda item? I know that we do have Mr. Thomas. Come forward.
Yes, sir.
Name and address, please, for the record.
Yes, sir. My name is Aaron Thomas. Address is 521 Bryan Drive in Denison, Texas.
Okay. How can we help?
Yes, sir. We recently acquired 144 Doolittle. I'm part of a LLC, my partner, Charles Edwards, and I. We acquired it, and we plan on paying all the taxes and any other liens against the property. Also, I spoke with Ms. Floyd earlier regarding the property and all the recommendations she had and requirements to get it back up to code, which is including repairs of the roof, electrical, plumbing, HVAC, and of course, securing the property as well. And, you know, pending you guys give us an extension to do that, we will have it done within, well within the, you know, 6 month standard time that you normally do.
So you said you just acquired the property or you're in the process of acquiring?
We have acquired the property and I have copies of the deed that's been executed and also the volume and page number as well.
Okay. Yeah, if you'll, you can give that to our city manager on the way out. So yeah, it sounds like you've spoken with our chief building official. I'm going to tell you what we tell all the folks that stand before us is you'll have 10 days to pull a permit. And then at that point in time, you'll have 6 months to complete the work. And we just want you to go eyes wide open before you spend any dollars, because if we get to down this road 6 months and you've got $30,000 into it, but you needed to put $70,000 into it, then the house is coming down. And just that's just the way we have to be to make sure it gets brought up to code in a safe way. We want you to be successful, want you to be able to rehabilitate the home. Just make sure you know everything that the building official is going to ask of you to bring it to code in order for you to be successful in that venture. So, how does, Judd, how does the taxes work? So if you closed on the property, then the taxes would have been paid during that process, right?
Well, we went ahead and signed a deed prior to actually closing. That way we can speak on behalf of the property today.
Okay.
And so, you know, we executed that side of it before actually getting any title insurance and understanding all the encumbrances that were already there. We went ahead and executed the deed anyway. That way I can go ahead and speak on behalf of them.
Okay. All right. And so when do you expect to close?
Well, it is already a sealed deal, just based on the way we did the deed.
Okay.
So it is, we are the owners of the property now. The taxes should be paid this week. All the county taxes will be paid this week.
Questions from council?
Just once again to reiterate what Mayor said, please make sure you've done your homework on these older structures, because there's a point where it's just cost effective to tear it back down and build brand new, as opposed to getting into some of the issues that you get into the older homes. So.
Yes, sir. And to make you guys a little more comfortable, 147 Doolittle, last year we acquired that property and we were able to get it back to half of the state, and it's a tenant in there and there. We've since sold it, but it was in similar dilapidated state as 144. So.
Okay. Glad y'all are doing it. Yes, thank you. Mm-hmm.
Is there anyone else here wishing to speak to this property? There being none, the public hearing is closed. Discussion from council? And a motion from council?
Mayor, I'll make a motion to extend and give the 6 months in lieu of tax, paying taxes.
Not in lieu of. He still has to pay taxes.
Oh, I'm sorry. Okay.
10 months to pull the permit. 10 days.
10 days to pull the permit. Six months to do the work, and the taxes are paid.
I'll second that.
Have a motion from Councilman Raleigh. Second from Councilman Spiegel. All in favor by saying aye.
Aye.
Opposed, like sign. Motion carries. Agenda 4B, unsafe structure, 314 West Hull Avenue. Ms. Floyd.
On November 9th, Betty Ann Childs Kane, Patty Badalak, James Childs Jr., and the Childs Family Partnership were given notice to repair and demolish the structure at 314 West Hull. The owners have failed to comply with the notice. The structure is unsafe and considered a fire hazard. The structure is also open, which creates an attractive nuisance. The foundation is failing on this. The roof, some work done to it. This is a shot of the inside. This also, the taxes haven't been paid on this one since 2008. And the amount due is $7,618. A record of the violations, notices, and unsafe condition of the property are on file in the building department. Staff is recommending council to declare the structure an unsafe structure and order its removal.
Okay, this is a public hearing. Is there anyone here wishing to speak on this property? There being none, the public hearing is closed. Discussion with council. And a motion?
Make a motion to approve the motion.
I have a motion from Councilman Hanley, second from Councilman Brawley, all in favor by saying aye.
Aye.
Opposed, like sign. Motion carries. Agenda item 4C, public hearing on unsafe structure posted at 405 West Walker. Denison, Ms. Floyd.
On November 9th, 2016, Curly McShan, Effie Bowden, Gladys Lucille Edwards, Johnny James McShan, and Keith McShan were given notice to repair or demolish the structure at 405 West Walker. The owners have failed to comply with the notice. This structure is unsafe and is considered a fire hazard. This structure is open, creating an attractive nuisance. The foundation, as you tell, is in pretty bad shape. Parts of the roof are in bad shape. The taxes also have not been paid on this one since 2011. Total due is $312.
Your taxes?
So it's not valued very high. This is a picture in the back. Record of the violations, notices and unsafe conditions of the property are on file in the building department. Staff is recommending council declare the structure an unsafe structure and order its removal.
Okay, this is a public hearing. Is there anyone here wishing to speak to this property? There being none, the public hearing is closed. Discussion from council.
Make a motion to approve demolition.
Second.
I have a motion from Councilman Hanley, second from Councilman Brawley, all in favor by saying aye.
Aye.
Opposed, like sign. Motion carries. Agenda item 4D, public hearing on unsafe structure posted at 501 West Hull Street. Ms. Floyd.
On November 9th, 2016, James A. Bowen was given notice to repair or demolish the structure at 501 West Hull. On December 22nd, 2016, Sochil G. Rios was given notice to repair or demolish the structure at 501 West Hull. The owners have failed to comply with the notice. The structure is unsafe and considered a fire hazard. This structure is open, creating an attractive nuisance. Foundation is in poor shape. The floors on the inside have had a lot of water damage to them. This is another picture showing how the foundation is lean. The taxes are current on this piece of property. Mr. Rios must have purchased it around December 22nd, or December 22nd, I think. So he must have had to pay the taxes, but we didn't hear anything from him. Our record of the violations, notices, and unsafe conditions of the property are on file in the building department. Staff is recommending council to declare the structure an unsafe structure and order its removal.
Betty, when did you say Mr. Rios was served papers?
December 22nd.
Is when they sent notice?
No, we sent the first one November 9th, and then this person came in and must have purchased it, and we consulted the legal firm, and they said that we did not have to send a 60-day notice to Mr. Rios.
Okay, this is a public hearing. Is there anyone here wishing to speak to this agenda item?
I am.
Please state your name and address for the record, please.
My name is Sochi Rios. The address is 501 West Hull Street.
And what address do you live?
765 Old County Road, Suite C, San Carlos, California. So I did acquire the property after all this. I didn't see the property, but I thought it had potential. The previous owners did have a rush in selling the house, and I had the money for it, so I didn't have a problem with that. I did think that there was something that's not well, but I knew that for the price of the home, I had to do a lot of work. And just by looking at the pictures, They put the nicer pictures.
Oh.
I just got the property today. I flew it in. I was really surprised. I'm meeting with a contractor tomorrow, and I still think that I want to go ahead and remodel by complying with all the city codes of Denison, of course.
Okay, so, and you currently live in California?
I live in California.
Okay, but you won't be here, I guess, during the construction, you're going to be
wrong? I will be here.
Oh, you will be here?
Yes.
Okay.
I'm planning to relocate my family here.
So again, we're in a tough situation, okay? One that you recently purchased, obviously, not inherited, or not brought upon yourself due to lack of maintenance on this building. So if it's the council's pleasure, again, what we'll do, I'll repeat what I told Mr. Thomas earlier, we'll give you 10 days to pull a permit, we'll give you 6 months to complete the work. And prior to you doing that, we want you to meet with the chief building official to ensure that you understand what it takes to bring it back to code. It's way past cosmetic repairs, as you can tell. So again, we just want to make sure you're completely understanding to what the International Builders Code is that we require in the city of Denison, and that you know what that is prior to really spending any of your investment dollars. Is the intent for you to sell it, to rent it, to move into it?
Move into it.
Okay. All right. Any questions for the property owner? Okay. Thank you. Is there anyone else here wishing to speak to this property? There being none, the public hearing is closed. Discussion from council.
Project. Big project.
Motion.
I'll make a motion that we afford the new property owner 10 days to pull the permit, 6 months to do the construction.
Second.
Motion from Councilman Hanley, second from Councilman Spiegel. All in favor by saying aye.
Aye.
Opposed, like sign. Motion carries. Agenda item 4E, unsafe structure at 820 West Day. Ms. Floyd.
On November 9th, 2016, Chase Home Financial, Crossline Mortgage Corporation, Linda Wagner, Robin Howard, and Mortgage Contracting Services were given notice to repair or demolish the structure at 820 West Day. The owners have failed to comply with this notice. The structure is unsafe and considered a fire hazard. The structure is open, which creates an attractive nuisance. The roof is in very bad condition. There's water damage on the inside of the property from roof leak. The tax is a current on this property. It's a foreclosure. A record of the violations, notices, and unsafe condition of the property are on file in the building department. Staff is recommending council declare the structure an unsafe structure and order its removal.
Okay, this is a public hearing. Is there anyone here wishing to speak to this property? There being none, the public hearing is closed. Discussion of motion from council.
I make a motion to go ahead and move forward with demolition.
Second.
Motion from Councilman Brawley, second from Councilman Hanley. All in favor by saying aye.
Aye.
Opposed, like sign. Motion carries. Agenda item 4F, hold a public hearing, take action on adopting change of zone to light industrial to commercial district at 3101 South Woodlawn Boulevard.
Council, you're asked to consider a change of zoning from light industrial to commercial, and this is going to be a two-part request. The first is for the zone change. The second is for a conditional use permit for office warehouse. And the applicant wants to rezone the property commercial to allow for an office warehouse and also to allow for maybe one or two additional lease spaces in this property that was previously vacant. The rezoning to commercial will be consistent with the zoning on the west side of Woodlawn. And as you're aware, the conditional use permit is also being requested. And the Planning and Zoning Commission considered this request at their meeting December the 13th, and they recommend approval. Staff recommends approval on this as well.
Okay. Since the public hearing, is there anyone here wishing to speak to this agenda item? Name and address, please, for the record.
Diana Armitage, Post Office Box 698, Calera, Oklahoma.
Yes, ma'am.
Now, I just wanted to let you know that we are planning on, we have a tenant interested in putting a dance studio in the west side of the building. So that's our main thing now. We wondered what, or we had talked to some other people about a restaurant, but it's definitely, if this passes tonight, she does want the extra footage for the dance studio.
Okay. And that meets with the commercial district requirements. Anyone else here wishing to speak to the agenda item? There being none, the public hearing is closed. Discussion and motion from council.
Motion to approve.
Second.
I have a motion from Councilman Hanley, second from Councilman Spiegel. All in favor by saying aye.
Aye.
Opposed, like sign. Motion carries. Agenda item 4G. Public discussion and public hearing on adopting a conditional use permit for office warehouse in a commercial district. Ms. Lloyd.
Again, this is the same applicant, same request, just need a conditional use permit for the office warehouse for their main business. And the Planning and Zoning Commission did approve this, and we are recommending staff that we approve this as well.
Very good. This is a public hearing. Is there anyone here wishing to speak to this agenda item? There being none, the public hearing is closed. Discussion from council. And a motion?
Make motion to approve.
Second.
I have a motion from Councilman Hanley, second from Councilman Brawley. All in favor by saying aye.
Aye.
Opposed, like sign. Motion carries. Agenda item 4H, public hearing on change of zoning from light industrial to commercial district at 4006 South Texoma Parkway. That's in this way.
Again, we have a previously vacant building at 4006 Texoma Parkway. The applicant is Jonathan Earnhardt, and they would like to zone this to commercial to allow for additional lease spaces, as well as he has a current tenant for a tattoo business. The commercial zoning is consistent with the existing districts there on the west side of Texoma Parkway. The Planning and Zoning Commission did consider this, and they recommend approval. And staff recommends approval on this request as well.
Okay, this is a public hearing. Is there anyone here wishing to speak to this agenda item? Jonathan, name and address, please, for the record.
Jonathan Earnhardt, 110 South Houston Avenue, Denison, Texas. We were first requested to change the zoning by our tenant and wanted to move in there and put a tattoo parlor in there. So we kind of overviewed the building and its uses and the commercial uses. We thought it was a good fit, being that most industrial buildings are now taller and set up different. These have a lot of small units. It's actually 12 units divided into right now. Whether it stays that way, we're unsure, but that's how we're kind of going forward with it. But it only has 10-foot ceilings in it and stuff, so it fit pretty good what we thought we could get in there, and so that's why we moved to do, go ahead and change the zoning. And of course, we'll do a little bit of remodel, try to make it look more like a commercial building and attract the commercial settings. And if y'all have any questions, I'm here to answer.
Any questions for Jonathan? Did I see that there's like wood over the windows?
Not wood. We had owner finance that building to someone else who's partially painted it. But
spray painted it?
Yeah, I don't know what they got out there and tried to do. But we are going to repaint it. We're actually going to replace a lot of the metal that's just bent. And stuff. We've started pulling permits. We just got our temporary power poles. All the poles, power's been stolen out of the building and stuff. So it's going to be a long process, but we're working on it.
Is there anyone else wishing to speak to this agenda item? There being none, the public hearing is closed. Discussion and motion from council.
Make a motion to approve.
Second.
Have a motion from Councilman Hanley, second from Councilman Brawley. All in favor by saying aye.
Aye.
Opposed, like sign. Motion carries. Agenda item 4I, public hearing, taking action on adopting ordinance change zone from agricultural district to single family 75 at 3100 block of West Stafford Drive.
Yes, the applicant are looking to rezone this property. It's currently agriculture. There's kind of a hole in the zoning districts. Surrounding zoning is pretty much 75. We think that based on the proposed use for this property, they want to put in replat some lots for a 41 lot subdivision for new single family homes, each being at least 1200 square feet. And the single family 7.5 is consistent with that type of development in that area. Planning and zoning considered this in December and they recommend approval, and staff recommends approval as well.
This is a public hearing. Is there anyone here wishing to speak to this agenda item? Name and address, please, for the record.
Brad Sylvester, 21 Tejas. I plan on doing 41 lots, like I said, single family homes, 1,200 to probably 2,200 square feet. Like I said, we just got to get it rezoned and engineered, and we're ready.
Good.
Let's see.
Is there anyone else here wishing to speak to this agenda item? Being none, the public hearing is closed. Discussion and motion from council.
Mayor, I make a motion to approve.
I'll second.
Have a motion from Councilman Hanley, second from Councilman Spiegel. All in favor by saying aye.
Aye.
Opposed, like sign. Motion carries. Mr. Sylvester, when do you anticipate the start date on some of your construction work there?
We're
redevelopment.
Meeting with engineers to get the plot laid out. We just got to get all these zonings and variances approved before we really move further. But once it's finalized, we're going to start moving forward.
Agenda item 4J, public hearing, take action on the use of a conditional use permit for warehouse office and door and window frame assembly in a commercial district at 4231 South Texoma Parkway. Ms. Lloyd.
The applicant, Mark Gamper, is requesting the conditional use permit for office, warehouse, and for door and window frame assembly. Much like the zoning that was granted just a few lots over for Lindsay Glass earlier last year, this would allow for them to build a brand new facility there on Texoma Parkway, and it would allow them to expand their existing business. The Planning and Zoning Commission considered this in January. They felt like that would be a good addition, very appropriate, and the staff is recommending approval for this conditional use permit as well.
Okay. This is a public hearing. Is there anyone here wishing to speak to this agenda item? Name an and address, please, for the record.
Hey, guys. Bob Moore, 732 North McCown, Sherman, Texas, with property interests. We will be providing the construction management for the new Denison Glass facility for Robert Toe and Mark Amper there.
All right. Anybody else here wishing to speak to this agenda item? Being done, the public hearing is closed. Discussion and motion from council.
Motion to approve.
Second.
Have a motion from Councilman Hanley, second from Councilman Brawley. All in favor by saying aye.
Aye.
Opposed, like sign. Motion carries. Agenda item 5A, individual item for consideration of accepting the resignation of Councilman Spiegel from place 4. Mr. Spiegel.
Yes, sir. Mayor, as we discussed, post-agenda issuance, I've submitted my resignation in order to run for the at-large position in May, and this is just simply a move in order to accommodate my family's desires to potentially move within the city and not be bound by my member district.
Okay. And I know, Ms. Fort, we've had you look into just what advice you'd give to the council, and you're prepared with that recommendation?
Yes, sir. It is appropriate to resign a position when you intend to run for another one. But just so everyone is aware, the Texas Constitution will require Councilmember Spiegel to hold over in the seat he currently has until his successor is elected in May. So even though you accept his resignation this evening, he will still be required to serve in the seat he was originally elected until the May election.
Required.
I was excited that that was an option. Right?
By the Texas Constitution.
I will be at every meeting. So.
All right. Motion from council.
Motion to accept.
I'll get a third.
A motion from Councilman Hanley, second from Councilmember Adams. All in favor by saying aye. Opposed, like sign. Motion carries. Council now go into executive session pursuant to Chapter 551 of the Texas Government Code to talk about contemplated litigation. And I'm missing a highlight here, but we're also, which one is on the Brawley deal?
Consult with attorney.
Consult with attorney.
I think they're all under.
Okay. Yeah. Contemplated litigation, premises maintenance, and the boat ride versus city. Time is 6:38.